Good morning. We at Enactus Kamala Nehru College believe that no impact is a small impact, and we strive every single day to make a difference.
The Kobla community is one of the oldest communities in India and has been one of the most neglected, exploited, and impoverished sections of the society. They survive in the absence of basic wages, healthcare, and sanitation facilities. Problems like poor working conditions, low and sporadic income flow, and social stigma have plagued this community for generations.
Project Kadam, which began 3 years ago, addresses these pivotal issues. From systematic empowerment of the Kobla community to waste reduction, resource recycling, and profitability, we inclined to work with reused and recycled fabric wastes and hence chose denim. We used textiles from different states of India, thereby portraying diversity in our handcrafted chappals. Under this project, we have empowered over 14 cobbler families, and in order to balance this all-male occupation, we worked with a group of women tailors who created the coordinated designs of chappals and pouches from the residual denim. Thus, denim worked like a gender equalizer.
We mapped out the basic challenges of the cobbler community by visiting various locations across Delhi. Through the interviews, we were able to gauge the actual situation and created a layout for an incentive-based system. We also conducted surveys for the target customers to understand the most frequently worn sizes and style appeal among the users.
For designing the chappals, we utilized the indigenous knowledge of our cobblers and used fabrics such as chikankari from Lucknow, fulkari from Punjab, batik from Bengal, and bandhej from Rajasthan, which facilitated in aligning our project with the Make in India initiative, along with the promotion of Indian textile and handicrafts.
Three basic raw materials, denim, soles, and value additions such as laces, frills, embellishments are used. We procure our denim through denim donation drives, purchase soles at affordable and competitive prices from Chandni Chowk and Karol Bagh, along with the sourcing of laces.
Our major target consumers were females from the age bracket of 18 to 22. Once we tested the appeal of our product, we branched out to housing societies and corporates. For pricing, we followed a two-tier pricing model. After having set up stalls in various college events and having received major exposure to our primary target market, through these fests, we negotiated with a crowd of 100 plus customers, understood their paying capacity, and worked out the market price. We set the price range from ₹300 to ₹350 for college students, whereas for housing societies, the prices range between ₹400 to ₹450.
All the cobblers are involved in the complete line of production, which transforms them from local cobblers into skilled craftsmen in shoemaking, who will be empowered to take a kadam on their own. Kadam is a step towards sustainable entrepreneurship, business innovation, and social responsibility.
We are limiting ourselves to denim to create a social welfare brand in the longer run. Having already started expanding our sales channels to online mediums using social media and our website, we shall now make our products available on the e-commerce platform Etsy. Our empirical projections suggest that by the completion of the fifth year of its functioning, Project Kadam would yield more than 40% increase in income of the cobbler community involved.
Denim is a soil coagulant and a toxic blend of chemicals, which pose a hazard to the environment. Through Kadam, we have managed to redirect and reclaim more than 80 kg of denim from landfills.
Kadam provides a stable and well-paying source of income to the cobblers. There has been an increase of 40% in the number of cobblers we were working with. This year, we sold 217 pairs of chappals in comparison to the 122 sold last year. This 77.8% increase in revenue has resulted in a 27% rise in the income of each of our cobblers.
Kadam has so far taken the social responsibility of more than 80 members, inclusive of 35 children. Further, we have also donated 40 plus chappals in the past year to women and kids, thereby impacting an additional 40 people.
Project Samarth centers around the idea of self-reliance, acceptance, and awareness. Our community of people who live with autism spectrum disorder have to grapple with stigma, insensitivity, and exclusion every day of their lives. Autism is a spectrum disorder. Each person with autism has a distinct set of strengths and challenges. The ways in which people with autism learn, think, and problem solve can range from severely challenged to highly skilled.
This entrepreneurship model is built around the idea of employment of the autistic community and channelizing a market avenue for their work to be showcased and appreciated for its worth. Our aim is sensitization, skill enhancement, and self-sustenance of the community. A Delhi-based organization called Action for Autism helps the community in effective employment, wherein they make different wear and goods by themselves.
इयररिंग बनाते हैं, इयररिंग जो है बहुत कम इंटर्न्स बनाते हैं क्योंकि बहुत फाइन मोटर की जरूरत है, बल्कि जो छोटी छोटी चीज को लेके उसको बनाते हैं, सो इसलिए वो बहुत कम इंटर्न्स बनाते हैं। और एक तोरण बनती, तोरण जानते हैं ना, मोस्ट ऑफ द इंटर्न्स बनाते हैं, सब इंटर्न्स बनाते हैं। और उसके अलावा अभी जो लेटेस्टली हमारा शुरू हुई है आर्गेनो जो स्पाइसेस है, तो वो स्पाइसेस को
We intend to expand this market and introduce new sustainable goods that can be made by the community here. We intend on producing 100% sustainable, recyclable and reusable material-based beeswax candles. These candles will be made from naturally obtained beeswax, used cooking oil and ground coffee remnants that are thrown in large amounts. When coffee grounds are dumped into landfills, they create methane, which is a greenhouse gas more harmful than carbon dioxide, consequently causing global warming. Our beeswax candles will be sold in an earthen clay pot, thereby providing additional employment to the potter community. The market for this product is huge and competitive, but with our prices and the associated benefit for the autistic, interests of customers will be attracted. We conducted a survey and the response for our potential products was optimistic, reinforcing our belief in this project. The survey showcased that the majority was likely to buy our products, especially for the beeswax candles. 67% of the population opted to buy them.
Our first initiative was on 14th February, Valentine's Day, where we spoke to people and distributed cards with information about Samarth. The aim was to sensitize as many about autism. In the light of COVID-19, we cannot conduct physical campaigns for a while, so social media will be our tool of outreach. We plan on starting a social media campaign called Samarthan Se Samarth. This will ensure accurate information, decimation and create awareness about the various struggles of an individual with ASD. In April, during Autism Awareness Month, we created a campaign by curating list of movies to know more about ASD and also debunk several myths that revolve around this disorder. Stalls at corporates like McKinsey, EY can be put up during their Diwali melas and other engagements, helping our community in turn, doing easy jobs like photocopying or printing, or organizing inventories for a day at such places would be of priority.
Contracts with PGs, bakeries, and grocery stores will allow us to achieve sustainability in the longer run and ensure a continued source of employment. We will also reach out to local cafes like Bisk, Cafe Bond, and Sugar Nama, who have an existing customer base for these products, to sell our food items like brownies, muffins, and patties.
काम है जो ड्राई फ्रूट्स का काटना, मोल्ड को सफाई करना है, मोल्ड को ग्रीस करना है, और जो हर एक मोल्ड में हमें मफिन का जो पेपर जो लगानी है, तो ये सब चीजें इंटर्न्स देखते हैं.
पोस्ट कोविड वी विल कोलैबोरेट विद आवर कॉलेज कैंटीन टू सेल आवर प्रोडक्ट्स देयर. ऑन अ डेली बेसिस आवर कैंटीन सेल्स एन एवरेज ऑफ 30 टू 40 ब्राउनीज एंड 100 प्लस पैटीज. At ₹40 a piece for a brownie and ₹35 for a patty, our revenue will amount to ₹4,900 a day.
According to our survey, 67% of the population showed an interest in our beeswax candles, and the highest proportion of interested people belonged to the age category of 16 to 20, making it our target audience. At a price point of ₹350 per candle, if the number of expected customers are 1,000, then our average revenue would amount to ₹2,34,500 annually.
With Project Samarth, we hope to achieve our objective of sustainable living and social acceptance, of difference, not indifference.
We are-